Endothermic and exothermic reaction. Endothermic reaction. The word endo is derived from the Greek words meaning within. An endothermic process absorbs heat from the surroundings into the system and results in an increase in the enthalpy of the system. During endothermic reactions, strongly bonded molecules are converted to weakly bonded molecules. Heat is converted into chemical potential energy and the temperature of the surroundings decreases. This is why the enthalpy of the products in an endothermic reaction is greater than the enthalpy of the reactants. So, delta H is positive, indicating that the reaction absorbs heat from the surroundings. That means enthalpy of products is greater than enthalpy of reactants. For example, at 0 degree Celsius and a pressure of 1 atm, ice melts to form liquid water. When ice melts, for instance, heat flows into the ice from the surroundings. Because heat is absorbed, the enthalpy of the liquid water is higher than that of the solid water. There are lots of examples of endothermic reaction. Let's discuss some here. Number 1. Cooking egg. Cooking egg is an example of endothermic reaction because the egg absorbs heat from the pan during cooking and doesn't release it. The heat circulates through the egg when it is cooking, making the reaction endothermic. Number 2. Dissolving antacid in water. Because heat was absorbed from the solution at the same time as the evolution of the gas was taking place. Next one is evaporation of liquid water. Water molecules must absorb heat from the surroundings to increase their kinetic energy. Then melting ice. Because ice cubes are absorbing heat energy from the environment and that energy causes the ice to melt. Exothermic reaction. The word exo means outside. An exothermic process releases heat to the surroundings and results in a decrease in the enthalpy of the system. During exothermic reactions, weakly bonded molecules are converted to strongly bonded molecules. So, chemical potential energy is converted into heat and the temperature of the surroundings increases. So, the enthalpy of the reactants in an exothermic reaction is greater than the enthalpy of the products. Delta H is negative, and the reaction releases heat to the surroundings. Enthalpy of products is less than enthalpy of reactants. For example, the combustion of methane is exothermic. It releases heat to the surroundings. The enthalpy change is negative because heat is being released by the system. Therefore, the overall enthalpy of the system decreases. Like endothermic reaction, exothermic reaction also have a lot of examples, such as burning of a candle. Burning of a candle involves combustion reaction. The wax is burning and turning into carbon dioxide and water. In the process, it gives off heat. Giving off of heat makes it exothermic. Again, formation of snow in clouds is an exothermic process because heat is being transferred from the system to the surroundings and the surroundings therefore heat up. Next one can be rusting of iron. This is also an exothermic reaction. When the pure form of iron or alloy comes in contact with the air or oxygen, rusting occurs along with the release of heat. Setting cement and concrete is also an example of exothermic reaction. The chemical reaction that occurs between the cement and water is called cement hydration. Cement hydration is an exothermic process. The mixing of heat with water will result in rapid liberation of heat for a few minutes. This evolution of heat is due to the chemical substances present in the cement like dye and tricalcium aluminate and silicate. That's all for this session. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to our channel. And if you have any suggestion or idea, please comment down below. Thank you for being with us.